Mr. and Mrs. Hollinger!
This is a backup plan B.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Thank you.
Okay, well, if you'll excuse me for just a moment.
Tony and Sons get this show.
Okay, what about the music?
Whoa. I'll turn it down and you take over.
Okay, I guess somebody's got to make a speech.
I can't think of anybody who's more qualified in the whole world besides me.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? Today we experienced a wedding, and I stand here like a puffed up pigeon because I'm so proud. Two very good friends of mine, very special people in my life, got married today. But I am sure that they are very anxious to get the hell out of here so they can be alone.
Amen.
However, we have certain amenities we must go through so we can get back to all the fun that we're going to have after they leave. So I'm going to call on Mr. Tony Jones to come up here and take over from me.
Okay, well, first of all,
I think we've got a minor disaster.
What?
I think the caterer left the top of the cake at the park.
Oh, no, we were so frantic.
I hope that's not a bad... Oh, no.
Mrs. Fulton Shore. Mr. Colton Short. Tony, they're to your left.
No jokes here, buddy boy. All right, well, I'm not sure how I got elected to this honor, but I'm glad that I'm elected to it. I'll start off with Colton. Now, over the months, I have gotten to know you as a good man and a good friend, and believe me, I was not easily convinced. But it came true. You're strong. You have humility and integrity. So I know you'll make a loving and kind and caring husband to her. You better. Because she's the favorite person in my life. And to Felicia, I don't know what to say. I mean, what can I tell you that I haven't told you a thousand times before? That you're a special part of my life, a very important part. But being a big brother to everyone, you know, I'm not sure that you know how much warmth and love you bring to other people's lives. I know. And everybody in this room, I think, knows. So tonight, as your marriage begins, you have love and hope and prayers from an entire room full of people. Every single corner of this room, I can feel it here tonight. So to Colton and to Felicia, I hope that you have as much happiness and light in your life as you have given to all of us.
Well, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Come on, Mark.
Well,
let's cut the cake.
Oh, Robin.
Hey, kid's got a point. Let it go. Hey,
yeah,
let's
cut the cake.
Let's cut the cake.
Now remember, you guys, you have to eat the first piece.
Okay. Since when are we such an authority on weddings?
Oh, she's an expert. She's been to enough weddings.
Haven't we all?
No, she went to mine.
Everybody ready?
Yes, do it.
Oh. Count of three. One, two, three.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Nice, number one. Nice, number two.
Here you go. Easy on us,
okay.
I'll get the plate.
That's the kind of
piece
I like.
Oh, you like that piece?
Oh, that's delicious.
We have to
first. At least as big as that, huh?
Yeah, right.
All right, don't bother with pork, honey.
Talk about him.
Man, an animal.
Oh, that's nice.
That's nice.
It is.
Standing here
on the stage alone, when shadows paint the scene, where spotlights used to fall, and now it's like a dream. Did it happen after all? Didn't I see you there, in silent silhouette, with love of your cigarette? It's like a shooting star. Lady of my heart, tell me who.
So far?
Scared, happy, excited.
Oh, all the usual symptoms.
And plus a feel I didn't expect.
You know, I think that despite the rain, it was an absolutely beautiful wedding.
Do you really think so?
Yeah. Well, look at yourself. You're absolutely glowing.
Well, I suppose you know better than anybody.
You've been through a lot of changes.
Changes?
Yeah, don't forget I was with you while you were running away from the fact that Colton killed Frisco.
Yeah, well, I found out the truth, so we got back together again. It's very, very special to me.
Just keep that special feeling. And Felicia, never look back.
There she is. Are you ready to go, my dear?
I am ready.
Oh, I'm
oh, my sweet girl.
Felicia, you're not going anywhere until you give the rest of us a chance.
Come on.
I couldn't help but notice how you and Sam were cutting the rug out there. It was great.
Oh, hey, you weren't so bad yourself.
No.
Who is that guy you're with doing the curly shuffle?
Oh, him. He's just somebody I picked up on the street.
Really?
Yeah, right up front.
Ready?
Physically.
Yeah.
Okay, Diane, group in. Oh, we've got one more cut.
Okay, here it goes, all right?
Oh, we're going to be married.
No. You'll find Mr. Ryan.
Very nice catch, Bobby. Now for all you poor single guys, time to improve your luck.
Oh, my God, that's just the thing to improve.
I thought you might.
Oh, I love this part. Hey, let me
go. There it is.
Not again. No more than you were of the bouquet.
I was talking with Walt.
Oh, so you say.
I think you're just covering up the family.
Oh, wait. What? Is that a kettle looking for a black pot, huh?
Here we go.
time. We're all set. We don't want to have to spend the night outside here, do we?
I don't mind spending the night as long as I'm with you.
Wait a sec. I think I remember better. It's a great idea to get dressed up like this, isn't it? There they are.
Looks like our camping person doesn't it?
Well, I guess we'll just have to make do with indoor accommodations.
I think I can do that.
Here we go. Whoa, wait a minute. Come back up here. We can't do that. You can't walk across the threshold.
Why not?
Because I have to carry you. Happy anniversary.
Anniversary?
Yeah. We've been married 5 hours now.
Mr. Colton,
sure. No, I'm not. I'm married to you. Come on. Find a light switch here.
No,
not
necessarily.
Mark,
it's better when things are off.
Let's see what this place looks like. Here we go. I don't believe this.
Oh, I do. This is definitely something Anna would do. Very nice.
Look at this place. Well, I'll tell you, if there is something else that we need to have a honeymoon, I don't know what it is.
Nobody around.
No Sean Donnelly.
No WSB.
Nobody, the buggus. Just you.
And me.
And me.
Forever.
A couple of roses. Did you hear something?
Uh-uh.
I think I heard something.
Where are you going?
I'm going to check and see who's at the door.
Why?
Honey.
Are you crazy?
It might be important.
Here we are in the middle of total wilderness and somebody's knocking on our door.
Yes, hi. Sorry to bother you, Miss Sir, but you see, my car's down the road, and it's stuck in the mud.
Oh, yeah, well, it's raining heavy outside.
Yeah.
Henry walked 2 miles to his service station, but it was closed.
Oh. Well, we got no place to stay, and it's getting cold up here in the mountains.
Can I leave your bathroom?
Yeah.
Oh, sweetheart. Yeah, sure, of course, but... excuse us a second. Yeah.
We're going to spend the rest of our lives with each other, aren't we?
Yeah, sweetheart, it's our honeymoon.
So what if we get off to a slightly late start?
Slightly late? Okay. Come on in.
Great.
Take off your wet coat. Yeah. Make yourself at home. I was just about to make a fire.
Well, I think the bathroom is right back there.
Thank you very much.
Please.
Thanks.
Relax. Be comfortable.
We're mighty grateful.
It's all right. Help yourself to some champagne.
Oh, great. Woo. Oh, it's a bad one out there, huh?
Yeah, it sure is.
Thank you.
rest?
Obviously one of Domino's assassins.
Didn't do a very good job this time.
As long as you thought you did.
As long as you're a dead man now, you can continue the mission until we've exposed Domino.
You gotta make sure that Felicia knows that I'm safe. Great. The WSB has got to let her know that I'm coming back.
We've got to get out of here before the terrorists.
Give me your word. Tell me you'll let my wife
know. Max, all right, tell me.
We'll
let her know.
Last night during the storm, there was a young family and their car went off the road and it got stuck in the mud.
We're back.
And you
are?
Well, they've been here all night and they're really anxious to get back on the road
again.
Want
some coffee?
Yeah. Okay, I'll wait.
We tried everything. All we managed to do was just roll it back deeper into the ditch.
Is there a store or something out there? I mean, where'd you get the newspaper?
A fella in a newspaper delivery truck tried to pull us out. It didn't work. Nice guy. He gave us a newspaper so we'd have something to pass the time.
Keep your fingers crossed. This is the last garage in town. Oh, yes? Yes. Oh, no, but, yes, I understand. Thank you.
Mm. No luck.
No, there wasn't any luck. He said that there are a lot of cars that got stuck in the mud last night, and there we'd have to wait all afternoon to wait to get a tow truck.
Folks, I'm really sorry about all this.
Now, don't be silly. If you do the same thing for us, we...
Well, I know, but... Well, at least you should get the first crack of the newspaper.
Oh, thank you.
Look, I mean, part of the reason that we came up here to the country was to get away from the city and the stress and be with people we can trust.
Well, that's nice of you to say that.
Today's, isn't it?
Truck driver said it was hot off the press. But you know, I feel that all your hospitality is really putting a big dent in your own vacation.
Well, a little bit of a dent. But look at the nice people we get to meet.
That's what I mean.
You want something to eat? I'm starving.
Promise and covenant before God and these witnesses.
And I do promise and covenant before God and these witnesses.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
What am I, kid? What are you gonna do about it, huh?
Nothing. Truce, okay?
I don't like cops.
I'm not a cop.
I don't like grown-ups either.
So I noticed.
I got a question. What are you doing down here?
I'm waiting for somebody.
Well, wait somewhere else, okay? This is my place. Me and my pal.
Well, you're welcome to it.
Well, fine, then go ahead.
Just as soon as I finished my business. You got any problems with that? Call a cop.
I don't need a cop to handle things for me.
Hey, don't push your luck, kid. I got bigger problems than you right now.
Hey, everybody down here's got problems, okay? Big deal.
I need a phone.
Oh, sorry, they haven't installed one yet. If you want one, you gotta go up to the penthouse. There's one up on the dock.
Well, I can't go up on the dock just yet.
What are you hiding out? Hey, look, I don't want any trouble down here.
Well, all the trouble's up there.
Come with me. Come on. doesn't look things any much dirtier than what you already got on. As long as this old wino lived here before me.
We'll save him for another time. Thanks.
Hey, look, if you're broke, I can show you how to work the phone, okay?
I got money.
Oh, yeah?
And I plan on keeping it.
What are you calling me, a crook?
I don't know what to call you.
Hey, look, just because I live down here doesn't mean I'm no crook.
Fine. Well, bye.
Hey, you know something? Ain't nobody gonna be crying if you never come back here again.
Well, that makes two of us.
It all happened on this day.
First things first, okay? Was I dreaming or did you ask me to marry you today?
Yeah.
I love you very much. Now you just hang tight, okay? Because I'm going to see you walking down those stairs again today, all right? I'll get back to you.
Hey, gorgeous. Anything in that newspaper about our wedding?
No, I really didn't get a chance to look.
Hey. I'm sorry. I know this has been rough on you. I mean, having these people here during our honeymoon, they're going to be gone soon, I promise.
They might hear you.
They went outside. I guess the kid got bored in here. I thought you saw them walk out the door and they just left.
No, I guess my man was on something else.
Not here.
Hi, good morning.
Hi.
Good to see you today. I brought you the paper.
Oh, good. See if there's anything in there about Felicia and Colt.
Actually, there is. There's a lot. I don't know where to begin. There's a beautiful article on the wedding.
Okay.
And there's a wonderful article about Felicia. And, there's such a gorgeous picture of the two of them together.
We'll save it all. I want to see it. If I ever get my eyesight back, that is.
When you get your eyesight back.
You're right. I don't have any doubts. I'm going to get my eyesight back.
Probably sooner than you think, too.
Yeah. Well, I was right. That was Mrs. Felicia Shore on the phone.
Yes, and did they successfully escape the storm last night?
No, it poured on them, but got there safe anyway. She just called me because the phone had been busy and she was afraid I'd be worried.
It was very sweet of her.
Mm-hmm.
Besides, I don't think that it would make much difference to a bride and a groom on their honeymoon whether it rained outside all night or not.
I hope not. I hope they had a fire in the fireplace and raindrops on their window pane for music. You know, Felicia seemed a little melancholy and I just hope that she didn't think about anything last night except her new life with Colton.
What could Felicia possibly have to be sad about, Tony?
Oh, just that today is Frisco's birthday. And it's also the day that Frisco and Felicia got married.
I had no idea.
That's because I'm taking the cure that I hope she's taking. Remember the past, live for today. Are you going to let me get sunburned out here or are you going to get me a beer? I worked out.
Okay.
I can get fat now.
My pleasure, Dr. Jones, please.
Thank you very much.
Don't worry about Felicia. I'm sure that the fresh air and the sunshine will cheer her up. Besides, that cabin home's very romantic.
Oh, it is romantic. Believe me, Anna, I do. They're all...
I love you, my sweet wife. But I've got some bad news for you.
I'm really sorry about all this.
The tow truck didn't come?
It came, all right. As a matter of fact, he yanked that car out of the ditch like it was nothing. But, you know,
when they hauled it up, it broke a stabilizer bar or something like that.
He said he wouldn't be able to have it fixed until tomorrow afternoon at the earliest.
Well, then why don't you borrow our car? You can borrow our car. We've got lots of food. We don't need a car for a couple of days.
No, actually, my wife and I had a little talk, and you folks have been so kind and patient, and, well, we're the ones that are stuck here. What we'd like to do is to stake you at a Class A honeymoon suite somewhere, our treat.
That's a very generous offer, but I wouldn't feel comfortable taking money.
Me and my wife, we had a wonderful honeymoon, full of nothing but beautiful memories, and we'd feel awful if we kept you from those same memories.
It's a really, really good idea.
Hey, and after the little ones come along, you really treasure the times you were able to be alone together.
I'll tell you what, I trust you. When you get home, you mail us this key, okay?
Fine. Hey, let me give you some money, too.
No, just hang on to your money. We're just going to hit the road, and we'll find a romantic honeymoon suite somewhere. You're coming up with the idea. Was payment enough. Thank you.
Now, they're very nice people.
Sure aren't very many people would be so helpful on their honeymoon.
Well, I know it really wasn't our fault, but I can't help feeling guilty for causing them all this trouble.
Hey, thanks, hon. Not much we could have done about it, hon. You know, besides, this way they'll have a real nice honeymoon, and when they tell stories about it, well, our part will be good for a laugh.
I hope they didn't have to drive very far.
You know, me too. I don't remember seeing any nice places on our drive out here.
We couldn't see anything through all that rain, remember? I think I better make some extra lunch, though, just in case they didn't find anything enough to come back.
If I was them, I'd drive all day if necessary. I'd stay in a rat trap of a motel if I had to. Who would want to share a honeymoon with two strangers and a child? That's you, punk.
Hello, Sean.
Yeah, so I've noticed.
No, I've never been happier in my life.
Maybe you ought to fix yourself that drink, huh?
I've got so many questions to ask you, I don't even know where to begin.
Fix the drink. I think you'll need it.
Well, I talked to the manager, and he said this is the best room in the place. He also assured me that this is the best motel within miles. Of course, what do you expect him to say, right?
Right.
I'm sorry this place is such a dump. Why, we're sure not getting this wedding off to a very good start, are we? I can tell you what. I'm going to open up one of those bottles of champagne that we bought. Maybe it'll help. Got one chilling right over here.
Look at the pillows.
Look at those.
It's
like
a harem or
something. Ooh, check out the fruit in the... We need champagne, huh? Whoa. Oh, sorry. I must look ridiculous.
No, you look absolutely wonderful.
Thank you. Well, look, I got these ultra special glasses for us. Very befitting the surroundings, eh?
Right.
A toast. What a day. Felicia, here is to the most wonderful wife in the world and the happiest man.
That's good. Now it's my turn. Here's to the happiest bride and the best honeymoon in the whole world, because you're with me. I don't want you to ever think you've ruined anything, because nobody's ever going to ruin anything between us ever again.
Yeah, a drink, yeah. What would you like to drink?
I'd like you to tell me what's going on.
What do you mean, what's going on? You're the one that just came back from the dead.
Don't play stupid with me. Decided not to read my note?
What now? What are you talking about? How long have you been back?
Hey, Sean. Shove your questions. Shut your mouth. And listen to my questions. It's like, how could you let Felicia marry this guy? You know what his name is? Sanctuary. They sent him to kill me, Sean. Or don't you care?
Just take it easy here, Fisco.
And what is with Felicia? She couldn't wait for me?
What do you mean she couldn't wait for you? We all thought you were dead.
That's bull. The WSB guaranteed me they would tell her that I was alive, that I was coming back. What happened to you? Sean Donnelly and Robert Scorpio. My two allies, right? The two men who introduced me to the WSB, who trained me, cradled me, brought me along. You know, I would love to see how you two would handle living in a Bulgarian prison for 2 years.
What Bulgarian prison?
The one I just escaped from, with two hitmen on my tail. Make that one now.
We'll get into that later. I think I better clear something up for you. Nobody pushed Colton and Felicia together. That just happened. And besides, Felicia almost lost her life twice trying to find you.
Save it, Sean. Don't lie to me.
I'm not lying to you. I'm telling you the truth. Frisco, we all tried to find you. Me, Felicia, Robert, we checked, we double-checked, we triple-checked.
And when you didn't have anything, you just wiped me off the face of the earth.
No. Until I found your grave. I found Frisco Jones's grave. Half hidden some motley field in Canada.
Did this.
Well, it would not be the first time.
You knew about it, didn't you?
No, I did not know about it. I did not know about it. And I just learned something about the WSB. Never, ever trust them.
Never trust them.
No.
You gave up. You gave up, Sean. You let me sit there and you let me rot in that sewer, aching for my wife every day. While you live the good life. And you play Cupid for this guy, Sanctuary.
Just come.
I looked up to you. And I trusted you. And worst of all,
thought you were my friend.
To wear when I come to pick you up.
A white shirt would help.
I don't have a white shirt.
Then wear a blue shirt. I don't know.
I have a t-shirt.
Oh, I don't care.
I know this is your living room.
Man, what happened to you?
I ran it.
Strong.
A little trouble. I don't know.
Here, get this thing off. Let me look.
I'm fine.
Get this thing off. Get it off now.
Careful.
Man, it looks like you got knifed.
I got jumped on the docks.
Hang on, I got some water over here. We're going to clean this thing up.
It doesn't look very deep.
Yeah, you got to clean it up anyway. Don't worry about it.
Hey, listen, if that's your new shirt, you don't have to bother.
Consider it borrowed, okay?
This really isn't necessary, you know, to go through.
Can you shut up while I'm doing all this, okay?
Need some help?
Here. Thank you.
You got a name?
Yeah. They call me Mouse. You laugh at it and you're going to lose your teeth.
Careful, Mouse.
It's not bleeding too bad.
Give me that. I got to get out of here. I'll tie it up.
You're going to get out of here or you're going to get out of Port Charles?
Port Charles, for good.
Uh-uh.
What do you mean, uh-uh?
You're not going anywhere. You don't know how clean this knife was.
I didn't bother to ask him if he'd cleaned it, no.
Well, you ain't going nowhere until you get some disinfectant on that thing.
Well, I haven't got time.
Tough, make time. Because otherwise you're going to wake up tomorrow morning with blood poisoning.
Well, I may wake up with blood poisoning, but I'm not going to wake up here in Port Charles.
Hey, look, is 10 or 15 minutes going to change your whole life?
I don't have a life in Port Charles anymore, kid.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Well, it's better you don't.
Boy, you're in a bad mood. You've had a rotten day.
I've had better, yeah.
Well, look, promise me that at least you'll stay here until I get something for this cut, okay?
All right. You got any money?
I don't need money for the kind of shopping I do. Man, you look like hell. Why don't you catch some Z's while I'm gone?
promised myself I wouldn't ask you when you have to go, but I have to know.
Do you have to know now? Can't we just pretend that I don't have to go at all?
What happens if I wake up in the middle of the night and you're gone?
That won't happen. I promise. You will not wake up in the middle of the night because I'm never going to let you go to sleep. Because I'm going to make love to you all night, and then when the sun comes up tomorrow, I'm just going to hold you in my arms and tell you how much I love you all day. All day.
Tell me who you are. You waited in the dark, and I need you with me.
Stings?
Not bad.
Well, look, I gotta step way down deep inside, otherwise it's gonna heal up, and then you're still gonna have the infection in there.
Oh, that's very good. You ever think about being a nurse?
Yeah, all kids think about it when they're little.
I guess so.
Now, the important thing is you got to keep this bandage on and keep it clean.
I'll do it, okay? Thanks anyway.
I get it.
What?
It's a chick. She's beautiful.
Hey, give me that!
Hey, she's the reason you're in so much trouble, huh?
Hey, listen, kid. Now, you forget you ever saw this, understand? Not that you'll ever see her, but just forget it.
You mean never tell her about you, right?
That's right.
Boy, you know what I'm starting to think?
I have no idea.
I'm starting to think that sex certainly isn't worth all this trouble it causes between a man and a woman.
Well, there used to be a thing called love. Not that you know anything about it yet.
Look, your bandage is done. Why don't you put this shirt on, okay? Cops!
It's not a police whistle.
It's my friends out at the entrance, man. Cops are coming. It's a warning whistle.
I gotta get out of here.
No, the entrance will be blocked, okay? We're gonna have to go deeper.
Me? I've gotta go. They're not after you.
Hey, look, how well do you know these caves, man?
Pretty well.
Okay, I know them better than you, so you go this way. I'm gonna go this way.
Listen, Mouse, thanks. Down here, I see some light.
Which way?
That way. You okay?
Yeah.
Come here.
What?
Listen. You got me away from the cops. You patched me up. But I still have to ask one more favor of you.
What?
I need this delivered to Robert Scorpio first thing tomorrow.
Okay, who's Robert Scorpio?
He's a police commissioner of Port Charles.
That's dangerous territory for me.
Well, I have full confidence in you.
Okay, I'll do it. Hey, up to tomorrow, I won't see you anymore, huh?
Probably not. Nobody's ever gonna see me again.
On the stage alone.
If I didn't love you so much, I'd stay.
And now it's like a dream. Did it happen after all? Then I see you there, in silent silhouette, the glow.
There's a reason for this obnoxious intrusion. Frisco's alive.
So, what's Side Bureau? Any more stonewalling on their part? I'm going to blow the lid off this whole thing.
Oh, come on. You know damn well you can't do that.
Sure I can.
Look, Robert, the only reason they are stonewalling us is because they are as surprised as we are that Frisco's alive. What they're trying to do now is regroup, figure out where they're going to stand.
You're trying to tell me that they didn't know that he was incarcerated?
I am convinced they didn't know a damn thing. Now, if you want somebody to fall off the face of the earth, all you had to do is shove them into a Bulgarian prison.
Well, it may not be today, or tomorrow, or next week, but sooner or later, someone's going to get him. He needs backup.
I mean, the man is devastated by Felicia's wedding.
Yeah. We've got to help him.
Now, first, we got to find him.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I understand. Yeah. Well, I didn't find him in the catacombs, but he's there. Yes.
Hi, it's Anna.
Yeah, well, what is it, love?
Can you come over here?
Now?
Yeah, right now it's important.
Is Catherine there?
Yeah,
she's here. In fact, if she hadn't been, I'd probably lost my mind by now.
Okay. Yeah, I'll be over.
Thanks.
You're thinking what I'm thinking.
And maybe Frisco went to Anna.
Yeah. She didn't say anything to me, but then again, Catherine's there. On the other hand, I don't want her or Catherine involved in this one.
You gonna tell her that I saw Frisco?
Not unless he's made some sort of contact with him. If he hasn't, then let's keep her in the dark. Right now, this guy is one magnet for any kind of danger going. I think he knows that, too. One thing he doesn't seem to know is how much he's going to need us.
You know, that's going to take one hell of a lot of convincing, Robert.
To be still alive.
Felicia. Felicia, are you planning on waking up sometime this morning?
Not until you call me by my real name.
Your real name? Oh, yeah. Sorry about that. Good morning, Mrs. Shore.
I like that. Say it again.
How are you feeling this morning, Mrs. Shore?
Just splendid, Mr. Shore. Promise me something.
Anything.
Promise me you'll be this happy for the rest of our lives.
I don't know if I can do that.
Oh, yeah? Why?
Well, because I think that every morning we wake up, we're going to be just a little bit happier.
I can't imagine being any happier than I am right now.
I'm glad to hear that. I was getting a little worried about you.
Why?
Yesterday you, I don't know, you seemed kind of down.
Yeah?
Yeah, I know that our honeymoon got kind of a wrench thrown into it because of those people showing up at the cabin.
Oh, no, I didn't mind it.
All right, then what is it?
Well, I
What is it, honey? What are you thinking about?
Food. I'm starving.
Oh, I should have known.
I'll get dressed.
No, you're not going anywhere. This is our honeymoon, and I am bringing you breakfast in bed.
But this is a motel, remember? They don't have room service.
No. I said, I'm bringing you. I'm going to go out and get it. Besides, I'm falling through the bed anyway, so I might as well get up. Oh, this motel room.
Well, I'll turn on the hot plate.
All right. And, keep the bed warm.
No problem. Do you remember what Anna said the day of our wedding? That she wished that we would be just as happy as she and Duke were.
Yeah.
Well, her wishes come true.
Sorry, ma'am, I must have the wrong...
No, this is the shore, honeymoon suite.
Wow, this is great.
Well, it's not exactly great. Maybe if we renovate a place, it might help.
What is this?
It's a candle. See?
Of course.
Don't burn yourself.
Sorry,
What do you got?
Instant coffee.
Instant coffee? Mm-hmm. Mounds and grown, no doubt?
No doubt. Mm-hmm. Pot to boil water in. Cups. Silverware.
Oh, finest English bone china.
Bowls, absolutely.
And the best silverware.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Muffins, cereal, milk, you got it all. Fruit, you name it, it's in there.
It's really good.
Mm. But you'll never guess what I have hidden so effectively behind my back. These are for you, Mrs. Shore.
These look like they've been fresh picked.
Mm-hmm. Well, they actually attacked me, and it was self-defense. I had to grab them.
I see.
You don't believe me?
No. Where could I go put these in the bathtub, maybe, huh?
Mm-hmm, good idea.
Why don't I get some water for the coffee?
Okay.
See if you can fix that radio. Sometimes it comes on and sometimes it doesn't.
I'll see what I can do. Oh, I called the cabin while I was out.
Oh, really? Did they fix their car?
No, believe it or not, the mechanic is still working on it. I tell you, magic fingers.
Magic fingers.
Mm-hmm. This is a great honeymoon.
I'm sorry. I wanted it to be so romantic, and it's not really
it old. It is romantic. Look at this. Look at this beautiful spread, this beautiful candle.
It's not a candle, it's a flashlight.
I don't care. Any place that you are is romantic. I mean, look what you did here. You took a dingy little hotel room and you transformed it into a completely different world. It's so beautiful. Felicia, what's wrong?
What?
Well, you were just kind of in your own little world there for a second.
Oh, no, it's nothing really.
What do you mean it's nothing? It's got to be something. What is it?
I don't really think I should go into it here.
Come here. I'm going to sit down and talk about this. Come on. Something is bothering you, I can tell.
I don't think I'm being very fair to you.
What do you mean? About what?
Well, yesterday you said I was acting very strange, and well, you were pretty close. I felt very strange. There was something I wanted to tell you, and I just didn't know how to go about telling you.
Tell me what? Did I do something wrong?
Oh, no. No, it has nothing to do with you.
What is it, then?
Miss Frisco, I just can't stop thinking about it.